concepts again that we were studying in the previous class about solutions, solvents, about solutes, right? If you remember, we studied them in the previous class as well, but again, I will be repeating. So we started that a solution is something which is made from the combination of two or more substances. It is a homogeneous mixture. It is evenly distributed, right? And basically, it's a mixture of two or more substances that stays evenly mixed. And the examples that have been listed on the slide are seawater, gasoline, glass, steel, and air. It is made up of two things. One is solute and the other one is solvent. All right. One is solute and the other one is solvent. Solutes are the things that are usually dissolved. When we take the example of salt in a water and we are able and we are going to dissolve it, we are going to stir it with the help of the spoon, and at the end we dissolve it. Just give me a minute. All right. So when we are taking the example of salt in the water, then salt is considered to be in a very small amount, whereas the solvent, which is water in this example, which we are taking, is present in the bigger amount as compared to that of the salt. Solvent is most of the time solid, but not all the time, and it is present in small amount. Whereas solvent, most of the time, is present in large amount, and it dissolves the solute in itself, right? And it is always a liquid. All right. So we studied about solutions, we studied about solute and solvents. When solutes dissolves itself into the solvent, we get a solution. All right, there are different kinds of solutions and all the types we will be studying later. All right. First thing that you have to keep in mind is a salt is a solution is a homogeneous mixture. All right, homogeneous mixture is a mixture that is evenly mixed, that is evenly dispersed. For example, if you take a bucket of water, right, and you add some jamishri in it, okay, jamishri, we are well aware of that jamishri, or you can also add any other thing and you keep on stirring it. ठीक है, और यू ऐड मिल्क एंड यू टेक द एग्जांपल ऑफ अ चॉकलेट सिरप इन मिल्क. ऑल राइट, यू ऐड चॉकलेट सिरप इन द मिल्क एंड यू कीप ऑन स्टरिंग इट. राइट, व्हेन यू टेक फर्स्ट स्टेप, इफ यू हैव कंप्लीटली स्टर्ड इट एंड देयर इज नो थिंग सेटल्ड एट द बॉटम, यू विल सी दैट आफ्टर यू व्हेन यू विल टेक अ सिप, यू विल ऑब्जर्व दैट इट टेस्ट द सेम थ्रू आउट. ठीक है, इट टेस्ट द सेम इफ यू हैव properly stirred it. So this is a solution, this is a homogeneous mixture. All right, so we studied about solutions, we studied about solutes, we studied about solvents. Right, now there are two other things that we are going to study about. One is solubility and the other one is insolubility. When a solute is completely dissolved in the solvent, we call it that it is a soluble, it is soluble. राइट, ये सॉल्युबल है उसके अंदर. द अमाउंट ऑफ सोल्यूट दैट कैन बी डिजोल्व बाय द सॉल्वेंट इज नोन एज सॉल्युबिलिटी, और अगर वो चीज डिजोल्व नहीं हो पाती दैट इज नोन एज इनसॉल्युबिलिटी. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वेन यू एड वन स्पून ऑफ सॉल्ट इन द वॉटर, ठीक है, हम उसको हल करते हैं एंड इट इज सॉल्युबल. राइट, वो डिजोल्व हो जाता है एंड इट इज सॉल्युबल. But when you keep on adding salt, for example, if you add 5-6 spoons of salt in one glass of water, आपने observe किया होगा after some time कुछ salt तो dissolve हो जाता है, लेकिन जो कुछ होता है वो bottom में present रहता है, because the water molecules have all been occupied with the salt molecules and there is no water molecule present to dissolve the other numerous amount of salt that has been settled at the bottom. ठीक है, एक point तक तो salt dissolve हो जाता है, लेकिन एक point के बाद salt dissolve नहीं होता, हम कहते हैं कि अब ये insoluble है, it is not being solubilized, it is not being dissolved. ठीक है, जब कोई चीज पानी में हल हो जाए we call it soluble, और जब कोई चीज पानी में हल ना हो we call it insoluble, पानी में या other solvent. We are taking water as an example because water is one of the liquids that can, you know, solubilize many different components as compared to the other liquids. Okay, so now we are moving towards two other very important terminologies. They have been listed on your books. One is homogeneous mixture and other one is heterogeneous mixture. So homogeneous mixture is one that cannot be distinguishable, and the solute is completely dissolved in the solvent. We take the example of water in the milk. All right, this is a homogeneous mixture and it is completely dissolved in it, right? And we cannot distinguish that what is water and what is milk, and it will taste same throughout. Then we have this heterogeneous mixture. In the heterogeneous mixture, the parts of the mixture are clearly, we can easily distinguish between the parts of the mixture, right? Agar we have a pizza slice, we know that this is sausage, this is pepperoni, this is the dough, this is the crust, this is the tomato sauce, and we can easily distinguish between them, right? This is known as heterogeneous mixture. All right, the composition is not the same throughout, whereas in homogeneous mixture, we have the same composition throughout. So we are going to discuss other important terms, which is one is known as dilute and the other one is concentrated. When you take a glass of water and you add small amount of, Tang in it or any other thing, you know, maybe jamishiri and anything, you can add in it. For example, when you take a glass of water, aapne uske andar one spoon of jamishiri add kiya, the color is slightly pink. ठीक है, पिंकिश रेडिश सा होगा कलर, बट इट विल नॉट बी स्ट्रॉन्ग इनफ. इसको हम कहते हैं ये डाइल्यूट है. ठीक है, इट इज डाइल्यूटेड. बट व्हेन यू कीप ऑन एडिंग अमाउंट्स ऑफ द सॉल्यूट इन इट, फॉर एग्जांपल यू आर एडिंग जामिशरी इन इट एंड यू आर एडिंग एनी अदर थिंग इन इट, उसका कलर चेंज होना शुरू होता है, डार्क होना शुरू हो जाता है. वी से दैट इट इज कंसेंट्रेटेड. We can add a little or a lot of solute. If the solute is present in a very small amount, in a very, very small amount, then we say that it is diluted. But when the solute is present in big amount or very huge amount, then we say it is concentrated. All right? Concentrated ka matlab hai jab solute bahut zyada amount mein present ho. For example, putting spoonfuls of sugar into a cup of tea. A solution with a large amount of solute is called concentrated. For example, if one student is taking a cup of tea, is drinking a cup of tea, and he is adding one teaspoon of sugar in it, right? We will say that his tea is diluted. He has only added one teaspoon of sugar. But if we see another person who is also drinking tea, but he has added 5 to 6 spoons of sugar, we will say that his tea is more concentrated because it is having more amount of solute in it as compared to the first one. The first one's tea is quite diluted, whereas the second one's tea is concentrated. All right. So now we are moving to, these were some important terms that we have been that we had to learn before we read anything. All right, so there are certain types of, on page number 69, certain types of saturations have been given, saturated solution, and there is the super saturated solutions. If we go out in a shower of rain and we are asked if we are wet, we may say our clothes are a bit damp. When we are dripping wet, we say our clothes are saturated. By this, we mean that our clothes will not absorb or hold any more water. We use saturated in a similar way when describing certain solutions. We are on page number 69. Kindly open that. So there are three kinds of solutions. So on your book, two kinds of solutions have been discussed, but we will be studying three kinds of solutions as we will be using the terminology later as well. So there are three kinds of saturations. One is saturated solution, one is unsaturated solution, and the third one is super saturated solution. All right, we are on page number 69. Kindly open page number 69. Okay, so saturated solution is a solution in which solute that dissolves until it is unable to dissolve anymore, leaving the undissolved substances at the bottom. Okay, Then unsaturated solution is the one, a solution with less solute than the saturated solution that completely dissolves, leaving no remaining substance. All right. If you take the example of, if you see the diagram over here on the slide, अनसेचुरेटेड सोल्यूशन एक ऐसा सोल्यूशन होता है जिसके अंदर सोल्यूट भी प्रेजेंट होता है और सॉल्वेंट भी प्रेजेंट होता है, लेकिन इवनली मिक्स्ड होता है. यू डू नॉट सी एनीथिंग प्रेजेंट एट द बॉटम. ठीक है, इसमें कोई चीज भी, तो हमें इस बात से, इस अगर फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू हैव टेकन वन ग्लास ऑफ वाटर एंड यू आर एडिंग वन स्पून ऑफ सॉल्ट इन इट, ठीक है, आप इसको स्टर करते हो, आप इसको मिक्स करते हो अच्छी तरह, और एट द एंड आपके आप देखते हो कि कोई भी अमाउंट या कोई भी सॉल्ट का पार्टिकल बॉटम में प्रेजेंट नहीं होता. ठीक है, तो हम कहते हैं कि ये अनसेचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन है. इसका मतलब है कि ये अपने अंदर और सॉल्यूट को डिसॉल्व कर सकता है, इसके अंदर कैपेसिटी है, क्योंकि अभी तक जितना भी सॉल्यूट इसके अंदर डाला गया है इसने बहुत अच्छे तरीके से उसको अपने अंदर डिसॉल्व कर लिया है और एक भी पार्टिकल हमें नीचे नजर नहीं आता. दीज काइंड ऑफ सॉल्यूशंस आर नोन एज unsaturated solutions. अभी ये और अपने अंदर सोल्यूट को डिसॉल्व कर सकते हैं. We have saturated solutions. Saturated solution is the solution in which solute which dissolves until it is unable to dissolve anymore. ठीक है, जब आप इसको थोड़ा काफी देर मिक्स करते रहते हो सॉल्ट को, अगर आपने टू स्पून ऑफ सॉल्ट सब ऐड किए, पहले आपने वन स्पून ऐड किया था, अब आप चले थ्री स्पून ऐड करते हैं. ठीक है, जो वाटर है वो बहुत से सॉल्ट के पार्टिकल्स को अपने अंदर मिक्स कर लेगा, अपने अंदर हल कर लेगा, अपने अंदर डिसॉल्व कर लेगा, लेकिन एक पॉइंट आएगा कि उसकी कैपेसिटी खत्म हो जाएगी. अब वो कहे, अब वो अपने अंदर और सॉल्ट को डिसॉल्व नहीं कर सकता, वो सॉल्ट बॉटम में प्रेजेंट होगा. ओके, वो सॉल्ट बॉटम में, जो सॉल्ट हमारे वाटर मॉलिक्यूल्स टेकअप नहीं कर पाएंगे, जो सॉल्ट वो उसको एब्जॉर्ब नहीं कर पाएंगे, जो सॉल्ट नीचे बच जाएगा, उस सॉल्यूशन, उस तरह के सॉल्यूशन को हम कहते हैं इट इज द सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन. इट इज अनएबल टू डिसॉल्व एनी मोर. अनसैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन में इट कैन डिसॉल्व मोर सॉल्यूट. ठीक है, सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन में इट कैन नॉट डिसॉल्व मोर सॉल्यूट. हम छोटे छोटे स्मॉल पार्टिकल्स छोटी अमाउंट में देखते हैं दैट इज सेटल्ड एट द बॉटम. देन वी हैव super saturated solution. All right, super saturated solutions are the ones that have more solute than the saturated solution, that contains more undissolved solute than the saturated solution because of its tendency to crystallize and precipitate. Theek hai, ab we have studied three kinds. All right, if you see, we have studied three kinds, unsaturated solution. Theek hai, can you see that there are some settled salt particles at the bottom? No, there are not. Yahan pe jo particles hain that are not settled at the bottom, hum thoda sa salt dalte hain, hum pani ko stir karte hain, we mix this and we see that salt has completely been dissolved into the solvent. We say that this is the unsaturated solution. It has quite capacity to absorb, to dissolve more solute. When we move towards saturated solution, this is the second example, we are adding more amount of solute in it. For example, in unsaturated solution you have added one tablespoon of salt, but in the saturated solution you have added three tablespoons salt andar add karte hain. After some time you will realize that काफी जो salt है that is being dissolved in that is being dissolved into the water, but there are small amounts, बहुत ही small amounts these, ठीक है, बहुत ही small amounts जो है वो bottom में settle हो गई है. Such solutions are known as saturated solutions. Now we are having super saturated solutions. If you are adding 5 teaspoons of salts in a glass of water, ठीक है, it is of course it is having more amount of solute in it. तो हम more amount of solute जब किसी solution में add की जाते हैं, हम उसको कहते हैं कि ये solution बहुत concentrated है. ये solution क्या है? It is quite concentrated. When you are adding more amount of solute into some solution, then it is known as concentrated. So our super saturated solution is extremely concentrated and it is having more solute as compared to both of these. All right, it is very concentrated, and at the bottom of the glass you will see that there is a huge amount of salt which is present undissolved. It is not being solubilized now, it is insoluble now. All right, crystals se niche ban jate hain, niche precipitate se ban jate hain, which indicates that it is a super saturated solution. All right, okay, if you see page number 69, if you see page number 69, the left side, one of these test tubes contain a dilute solution of copper sulfate and a concentrated solution. And then we have the saturated solution of copper sulfate. Which test tube is which? All right. The one that is having the lightest color, jiske andar color bahut light hai, wo indicate kar raha hai ki iske andar amount of solute jo hai, it is less as compared to the other test tubes. Test tube number 3 is the dilute test tube. Iske andar bahut hi kam amount hai solute ki, as it is having light color. Theek hai, copper sulfate ko inhone dissolve kiya hai. Copper sulfate is basically of blue color and it is also known as commonly as neela tota. It is very poisonous. Isko ghar mein bhi banaya ja sakta hai and it is very poisonous. So the copper sulfate crystals are dissolved into a solvent. Theek hai, टेस्ट ट्यूब के कलर से अंदाजा लगा सकते हैं. टेस्ट ट्यूब के कलर से अगर आप देखें अपने पेज नंबर 69 पर, लेफ्ट साइड पर बॉटम में 3 टेस्ट ट्यूब्स दी गई हैं. वन इज द डाइल्यूटेड वन, ठीक है, देन वी हैव द सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन. इफ यू सी द सैचुरेटेड सॉल्यूशन, टेस्ट ट्यूब के बॉटम में थोड़े से क्रिस्टल सेटल है. सेकेंड टेस्ट ट्यूब में आप देखें थोड़े से क्रिस्टल जो है दैट आर प्रेजेंट एट द बॉटम. So we say that it is a saturated solution, but we have the third test tube jiska color bahut zyada dark hai. Hame ye indicate ho raha hai ki iske andar bahut hi zyada solute add kiya gaya hai, bahut hi zyada crystals add kiye gaye hain, aur crystals bottom mein kafi zyada settle bhi hue hue hain, kafi zyada settle hai. So it is the concentrated one. Theek hai, to aapko yahan se andaaza ho jayega which test tube is which. The first one is the concentrated one, the second one is the saturated solution, and the third one is having a dilute solution in it. So now we are moving towards page number 70. We have done the first paragraph in which about super saturated solution have been given, and then we have also read that in the super saturated solution the solute cannot dissolve itself in it and the crystals are formed at the bottom of the container until the normal level of saturation is reached. ठीक है, इन तरह की conditions में एक तरीका ये होता है कि you heat the solution. जैसे ही heat provide की जाती है तो solute की जो amount है वो और ज्यादा dissolve अच्छे तरीके से होना शुरू हो जाती है पानी में. All right, now we are moving towards another very important topic, which is the easiest one. All right, water which is the universal solvent. All right, many substances that dissolve in water at least to some extent, that is why water is often called the universal solvent. River and lake water dissolves mineral from the rocks through which the water has flowed. The minerals are mainly salts of calcium, magnesium and sodium, and this is known as hard water because compared to the rain it is more difficult to get a lather with soap. You see the hardness in the water if you look inside the empty kettle where the minerals form a coating in it. Fish can live in water because it dissolves a small amount of oxygen gas. Water plants use the carbon dioxide dissolved in water to make their food through the process of photosynthesis. In the home we use water to dissolve sugar, salts and spices in our cooking. We also use it to make drinks such as coffee, cocoa and tea. When washing, we use water as a solvent because it dissolves many kinds of dirt and stains. Water can also dissolve detergents, and a solution of detergent and water can remove dirt and stains that water cannot remove. So certain examples of water has been given on your page number 70, in which it has been indicated that water has immersed use in the field of farm, in the field of agriculture, in the field of industry, even in our homes and in our households as well, right? So there are two kinds of water. Basically, what happens when the rain comes, right? When there is hail, rain, and snow, mountains ke upar there are certain different kinds of salts that are present. Most of the time, jo water hai, wo dissolve kar leta hai apne andar wo salts, theek hai? Jab बारिश का पानी माउंटेन्स के ऊपर पड़ता है, उसके ऊपर सॉल्ट्स होते हैं, वो बहुत सी अमाउंट उन सॉल्ट्स के अपने अंदर डिसॉल्व कर लेता है, एंड देन इट टेक्स द सॉल्ट्स इनटू वेयर, इनटू द रिवर्स, इनटू द लेक्स, एंड इनटू द अदर वाटर बॉडीज, राइट? जब वो उसने अपने अंदर सॉल्ट डिसॉल्व कर लिए, बहुत से मुख्तलिफ सॉल्ट्स डिसॉल्व करता है, ठीक है? उस बेसिस पर हम इसको कहते हैं, जब वो सॉल्ट्स ऑफ कैल्शियम एंड मैग्नीशियम को अपने अंदर डिसॉल्व कर लेता है, तो हम कहते हैं कि ये हार्ड वाटर है. देयर आर बेसिकली टू काइंड्स ऑफ वाटर, वन इज हार्ड वाटर एंड द अदर वन इज सॉफ्ट वाटर. हार्ड वाटर के अंदर यू हैव एन आइडेंटिफिकेशन, हार्ड वाटर हैज लेस अमाउंट ऑफ बबल्स इन इट, इट इज नॉट फ्रेश, इट हैज, इफ यू सी द स्लाइड, इट हैज मिनिमम बबल्स एंड द वाटर इज नॉट वेरी क्लियर, इट इज अ क्लाउडी वाटर. But on the other side, if you see the soft water, it has lots of bubbles in it. It is fresh and it is quite clear one, right? Well, hard water mein ye hota hai ki bahut se salts jo hain wo iske andar dissolve hote hain, salts of calcium, salts of magnesium, right? Aapne hard water ko observe kiya hoga, if you have seen a kettle, theek hai, jisme hum pani garam karte hain. आपने कैटल को कभी यूज किया हो तो आप उसको जब लगातार यूज करते हो, कॉन्स्टेंट यूज करते हो, आफ्टर सम टाइम यू ऑब्जर्व दैट देयर इज समथिंग वाइट मटेरियल, वाइटिश मटेरियल जो है वो कैटल की पाइप्स के साथ जुड़ जाता है, राइट? दैट वाइटिश मटेरियल इज ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ सॉल्ट्स इन द वाटर. उस पानी को हम कहते हैं हार्ड वाटर. हार्ड वाटर को ट्रीट किस तरह, पर टेम्परेरी हार्डनेस ऑफ वाटर कैन बी ट्रीटेड यूजिंग हीट. जैसे ही हम पानी को बॉयल करते हैं तो हम टेम्परेरी हार्डनेस ऑफ वाटर को आसानी से रिमूव कर सकते हैं. इसी वजह से कैटल के अंदर हार्ड वाटर को जब गर्म किया जाता है तो उसके अंदर जो सॉल्ट्स प्रेजेंट होते हैं दैट स्टिक टू द पाइप्स ऑफ द कैटल. दिस इज ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द सॉल्ट्स ऑफ कैल्शियम एंड मैग्नीशियम इन टू द वाटर दैट यू आर कंज्यूमिंग. सो देर आर टू काइंड ऑफ वाटर एंड हार्ड वाटर एंड इट इज वेरी मच डिफिकल्ट. ओके, it is very much difficult to form leather with soap. agar aap uske paapne haath dhote hain, agar aisa pani jiske andar salts of calcium and magnesium present hai aur agar aap usse haath dhote hain, then you do not form leather easily. aapko zyada aasani se jhag nahi banti. whereas when we see soft water, it does not contain the salts of calcium and magnesium and it can form leather with soap easily. ye jaldi se apne uske sath jhag bana leta hai, right? Hard water has its certain disadvantages because more wastage of time and fuel as boiling temperature of water gets increased due to impurities. Whereas when we have soft water, we have less wastage of time and fuel. अगर एक पानी है उसके अंदर impurities present है, उसके ऊपर salts present है, तो वो बहुत ज़्यादा time लेता है to boil. और ये बहुत ज्यादा टाइम और बहुत ज्यादा फ्यूल भी कंज्यूम करता है. वेयर एज सॉफ्ट वाटर में क्योंकि सॉल्ट्स और इम्प्योरिटीज प्रेजेंट नहीं होती तो ये लेस टाइम लेता है. इसके अलावा हमें सोप की लेदर नहीं बनती तो हमें सोप भी ज्यादा कंज्यूम करना पड़ता है. वेयर एज सॉफ्ट वाटर में जल्दी लेदर बन जाती है, जल्दी सोप की लेदर बन जाती है, इसलिए हम कम से कम सोप को यूटिलाइज करते हैं. सो देर आर टू डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ वाटर विच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, वन इज हार्ड एंड वन इज सॉफ्ट. All right, हमने वाटर के यूजेस देखे. द वाटर इज यूज इन फोटोसिंथेसिस, वाटर इज यूज इन मेनी डिफरेंट थिंग्स. इट इज ऑल्सो यूज टू मेक कोल्ड ड्रिंक्स, इट इज यूज फॉर द प्रॉपर ग्रोथ ऑफ आवर वेजिटेबल्स एंड फ्रूट्स. मोस्ट ऑफ द मास ऑफ ह्यूमन बॉडी एज वेल एज ऑफ डिफरेंट एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स हैव वाटर इन इट. ठीक है, हमने देखा है कि ह्यूमन बॉडी में वाटर की अमाउंट बहुत ज्यादा होती है, रफली अप टू 70%. इसी तरीके से काउस में, इसी तरीके से डिफरेंट एनिमल्स में उनको पानी चाहिए होता है बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ देयर वेट इज ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ वाटर. ऑलराइट, सो देयर, और इसके अलावा पानी के अंदर बहुत से वाइल्ड लाइफ भी प्रेजेंट है, वाइल्ड प्लांट्स भी प्रेजेंट है, वाइल्ड एनिमल्स भी प्रेजेंट है. Furthermore, water has a very important use of, you know, washing our clothes and washing our dishes. Because why? Because water can also dissolve detergents, ठीक है, जो कि दूसरा फ्लूइड डिसॉल्व नहीं कर सकता. वाटर कैन डिजोल्व डिटर्जेंट. जैसे ही वाटर दोनों एक दूसरे के साथ मिलके दोनों एक दूसरे का काम आसान करते हैं, जो दाग पानी से नहीं जाता वो डिटर्जेंट से जाता है, और डिटर्जेंट और वाटर आपस में एक दूसरे के साथ मिलके दे वॉश द क्लोथ्स. ओके, फर्दर मोर वाटर इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द कुकिंग पर्पज. ऑल राइट. When farmers and gardeners spread chemical fertilizers on the soil, rainwater dissolves the chemicals so that they can take up by the plant roots. Sometimes crops such as tomatoes and strawberries are grown in greenhouses. We have studied about greenhouses many times now, without any soil. Instead, the plants are grown in a solution of mineral soils, plant foods dissolved in water. Water is also widely used in industry in the manufacture of foods, drink, textiles, shampoo, soap, detergent, cement, and concrete. So whenever you might have seen different kinds of fertilizer ad that are coming on the TV, if you have seen in the real life, what farmers do, they take up the important nutrients, important chemicals that are having nutrients which are very much essential for the growth and development of the plant. What they do is that wo us solid particles un fertilizers ka lete hain, they spread it to the whole ground. All right. And they water it. वाटर के अंदर वो जो मिनरल सॉल्ट्स हैं वो डिसॉल्व हो जाते हैं, और प्लांट्स जो हैं वो अपने रूट्स के थ्रू, अब चूंकि सॉइल में वो सॉल्ट्स ज्यादा प्रेजेंट हैं दैट आर वेरी मच हेल्पफुल फॉर द ग्रोथ ऑफ द प्लांट, सॉल्ट्स और पानी आपस में मिक्स हो जाता है, और प्लांट्स जो हैं दे कैन नाउ इजिली टेक अप द सॉल्ट्स थ्रू वाटर विद द हेल्प ऑफ देयर रूट्स. सो दैट इज वाई बिकॉज ऑफ द great and infinite properties of water, it is also called as water the universal solvent, as it can dissolve huge amount of things in it, and it is also used in different multiple fields, and it is basically our life. Water is our life. That is why it is known as universal solvent, as it is able to dissolve different and great amount of solutes in it. So we studied till page number 71, water the universal solvent. The chapter is quite an easy one, you just have to read it on daily basis. Right, I'm done with my lecture for today. If there are any questions, you can ask me in the chat box. Sameer, what happened? Sameer, we were on page number 71. I was just explaining you. Do not worry, and I guess you have some problem with the autocorrect thing. Thank you, Respa. Thank you so much. Thank you, Amuz. If you guys are having any question, all right. What happened, Ubaidullah? You have written a big message jiski koi wo nahi hai. Okay, I guess this is the autocorrect issue. All right, everyone. Take care, Junaid. Take care, Amuz. Take care, everyone. Take care, Alicia, Rispa. Everyone, take care. Eric, if you have any questions, then you can kindly ask me in the chat.